wears the trousers in a pantisocracy?
Oh, it's one of those kinky parties where people turn up in either panties or socks. You take a choice.
It has got the word all in it, so panto for all, and then we have...
Socracy.
Socracy, so from isocratia, so equality of power. So basically it is government for and by...
Everybody.
All, yeah. So it was a... Yes, Charles, you don't rarely ask permission to speak.
Well, I know there are bonus points for courtesy.
Oh, yes, very good. What were you going to say, Madeline?
I was going to say that I've actually lived in a pantisocracy.
Have you?
And it's hell. When I was about 17, a master from our school...
Where's this going?
He was subsequently arrested, but that is a different story. This master invited some of us to go on holiday to Devon. And he said, we are going to be pantisocrats. And the idea was we went to a village where Coleridge, the poet, had been on holiday. And he told us that Coleridge and a friend of his, I think Southey...
Robert Southey.
They had invented this idea of a society where everybody was equal.
Yeah.
And on this holiday, all eight of us and this one teacher lived this life of being equals. And we all had to be different romantic poets. I ended up as Byron. It was a ghastly, ghastly experience. and it put me off equality forever.
Yes.
And this led to what we all had to do on this holiday.
Okay.
The idea was we were all asked to be different poets, and the fellow who chose to be Southey told us the story of the three bears. I had chosen to be Byron. Not Lord Byron, but his cousin, H.J. Byron, Henry James Byron, the man, as you know, Sandy, who invented Widow Twankey for the pantomime Aladdin and also created the character of Buttons. OK, you live and learn. And 3 weeks of this, somewhere in Devon, all pretending to be characters... It was hell. It was sheer hell.
3 weeks?
Yeah. He, the master, of course, was on Coleridge and took it seriously, which meant taking opium. He was a druggie.
Did you at any stage in the 3 weeks stop talking?
One would have liked to have seen you give your twanky.
No.
But to live, to method act the creator of Widow Twankey for 3 weeks.
But also, isn't it appalling that this great man, H.J. Byron, is virtually unknown? He was the first cousin of Lord Byron. Nobody is reading Byron anymore. Byron Schmyron. But we, every Christmas we go, we cheer at Buttons, Widow Twankey, we love her. Nobody even knows that this man exists.
How did he write just those characters?
He wrote the whole show, but I'm cutting to the chase because I don't want to take up too much of your time.
But I also, I desperately want to know whether you chose H.J. Byron or whether he was imposed upon you.
Just one tiny second, Jazz. Do not ask him any supplementary questions. What are
you thinking?
What's wrong with you? Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Well, please, come on, pick something.